George, is there anything we can do for those people? Of course, we want to pray for them, but what else can we do to help them? I mean, it's just a surrender by Biden and these people. It makes me sick at my stomach when I think of what's happening. It's horrible because these people are considered apostates and they can be beheaded.
Yeah, it's absolutely tragic, Pat. Just moments before coming on the air, I got a text message, a WhatsApp message from another underground church leader, this time in Kabul, and he said, my family, these are his words, Pat, he said, my family is on the run, but they do not have passports. I said, how can we pray for you? He said three things. One, pray for safety and protection. Number two, pray for provisions for the displaced families. And number three, pray for evacuation and a way to get out for those who decide to leave. And then he said, pray for boldness and courage for those who decide to stay in the country and face the wrath of the Taliban. And the reality is that as we see tens of thousands of Afghans who worked with the coalition forces, who worked with American forces trying desperately to get out, then you have families like Hamid's who are stuck. They don't have passports. They're not necessarily connected to the coalition forces or anyway, but they're stuck and they realize they can't head to the borders because the Taliban control the entire borders, all the borders to Pakistan, Tajikistan, and Iran. And they're stuck, literally stuck. And it's a really difficult situation. So we need to pray for them desperately, Pat.
Thanks, George. You remember, pray. They need provision. They need protection. But do they need the anointing of God? There's got to be angelic hosts to protect them. But to think that our feckless president said there was no way. Of course there was a way. It never happened under Trump. He told the Taliban, and we had Mike Pompeo on this program, and they made it clear to the Taliban, you touch one of our people, and we're going to come after you with all of the power we've got, or we'll destroy you. And so they never did it. They never touched one single American. And the idea is that the last thing you would do is evacuate your civilians. You'd take them out first. You'd leave your army in place. You would leave control of the Bagram airfield. You would make sure that all of your material got taken out. That's what Trump said. If you want to, we'll turn the thing over, but only under certain conditions. And if you break one of these, we're going to come on you with both feet. I heard Senator Lindsey Graham on, I think, last night, and he was really strong. He said, listen, we ought to have a safe corridor, and we ought to tell the Taliban that if they violate it, we're going to come after them with everything we've got. And I was listening to Sean Hannity, who would much prefer having the people all stuck and then say, well, isn't Biden terrible? But I think that Lindsey Graham had it right. We need to tell these people we're not going to stand for this. We're not just going to sit idly by and let you persecute everybody and kill Christians and behead the believers and also force women into sex slavery. We're not going to let it happen. We're so concerned here about the Me Too movement and all this stuff here in America. And here we have surrendered all those wonderful women in Afghanistan to slavery under the Taliban. We can't do it. And we could come out there and get our people out, but it would take a lot of courage and a lot of strength. And I don't think the Secretary of Defense or General Milley have the guts to do it. And I certainly don't think the president has what it takes to be the commander in chief of the United States.